All right, so we used up the caffeine that we piled up on the ground right over there, and so we're gonna use that little white trailer. So we're gonna mix up caffeine and then figure out how we're gonna load it into the trailer. So we need 3,000 pounds of corn. Now we need 2,000 pounds of this three-way mix. It's got corn gluten, soy hulls, and DDG in it. So now we need about 800 pounds of soybean meal. Gotta get 200 pounds of medicated calf mineral. Should be 4 bags. Thank you. not too sure how this is gonna work out, so we'll have to figure it out. I don't know if I can dump straight into it with the wagon, or dump the feed into the bucket and then dump it into the trailer with the loader. So we'll just see how it works.
It's full right here.
I don't, it's closed.
Try to get as straight as you can and close to the wall. Huh? Yeah, I think first I'm gonna try to pull the wagon in. See if I can dump it in. There, right there.
I think I can reach over into the trailer. I just don't know if I can get close enough to actually really dump into it. So we're gonna see. The conveyor's got a dog leg, so it only goes down so far. I can put some donuts in and keep it up higher, but that ain't gonna really help. Let me pile it up like a foot and it's gonna be on the conveyor. You can do a little bit that way, but you're gonna do 6,000 pounds. This is giving me a pain in the butt.
Well, that's 4,000 pounds so far. We have 2,000 more pounds to go. Fit in the trailer, we'll just dump there and then I can shovel it later. Right now we need to shovel the middle out into the corners. shovel it, or are you going to take a couple buckets with you?
Shovel.
Got two shovels per bucket. So. Yeah, that works first.
That's fine.
I'm hoping it's close to the shop.
Just a shovel, if you're between the pile into the trough, if it's gonna like be flying off and blowing off and all that. Yeah. But if we ever get an extra guy. The extra guy can ride right here with a scooper and then fill into the cap hutches and you just drive down the cap hutches.
That's gonna be pretty sweet with this.
I mean, we're only supposed to have 300 babies in the first 60 days that's coming this cabin season. So.
You see how it is with the shovel. Might be easier right now. So full, might get harder at the end. So I need to have a bucket, you know, down at the bottom. But
yeah.
And, you know, trying to get the last little bit out.
Yeah.
I gotta find a little park in the old barn.
Huh?
It's gonna park in the old barn?
Yeah. I mean, the only thing that's gonna be. But every time you get down to the end, you're going to have to clean it all the way out, you know?
Yeah.
Won't be able to just leave it pile more in. And you just have, like, rotted crap at the bottom.
Right.
You could do one trailer load, and then you'd be like, oh, I want the buckets back.
Yeah.
And it sounds easier.
Yeah. To me, it sounds like you're eliminating a step.
Filling the buckets up.
Filling the buckets up, and then taking the buckets and dumping them. Why not just take the pile of feed in?
Yeah.
Put it back to the trunk. Seems like it should work.
But I'm just guessing there's 5,000 pounds in there.
Okay.
There's 1,000 pounds left over there. So that's like 4 days worth in the trailer. Right?
Yeah.
You could get some like plywood and some 2x4s and make some extensions. And then, you know, if the other thing is that the trailer can handle carrying 6,000 pounds out there. And then if there's like no problem, nothing tweaking or breaking or whatever, just make like a 2 foot tall extension. And then once you get down to this level and you take the extensions off for a couple days.
Yeah, do something like this.
Yeah. Rather than making cat feed every other day, filling it up every other day. Had to like shove off the back or something. I don't know. Okay. See ya.
Right here?
No.
You want to see it in action?
No, I'm good. I'll stay here and make feed the real man's way.
Okay.
You go ahead and go play with your toys. So this is how we've been putting out grain buckets. These are just 15-gallon barrels that we cut up. You know, know, just cut this middle out of the barrel out to make buckets. You know, get a bucket on each end and drill a hole, run a rope through them. You can get a water hose, cut a water hose, make a nice handle. That way the rope's not digging into your hand. And then this bucket filled all the way up would be about 40 pounds of grain. Like if I was to do the buckets, I would probably pull up there, lay the ramp down, carry all the buckets off, put them around the pile, and then shovel and fill them up, and then pick them up, load them, carry them back onto the trailer. Jason just ended up just leaving them on the trailer and just throwing the feed onto the bucket, into the buckets that way, which kind of, you can see the feed piled up, and then every so often he would clean the trailer off. Just because unloading and loading them back up was kind of a pain in the butt. Which this works just fine if you're doing 20 buckets a day or so. But right now we're up to the point of doing 60 to 80 buckets at a time. So he'd have to fill his trailer up three different times to get everything, all the calves fed. So it just becomes a pain in the butt and a hassle. And if you got two guys, it's not that bad, but it still takes a while. And then if you're by yourself, it's kind of miserable. So hopefully that trailer, just loading it straight onto the trailer, takes out the filling the buckets up and dumping the buckets out into the troughs. You can just shovel it right out of the trailer into the trough. So we're going to give that a try and see if that's any easier. It would definitely be easier going down the calf hutches and see how the buckets are mounted onto the front of the panel. So you can, if you got two guys, which I think it'd actually be still easier if you're even by yourself, but two guys, one can ride on the trailer and dump the feed into the buckets rather than, I don't see it, but one way to do it is to carry the bucket and dump so much in, or we have a little, I don't see it around here, it's probably on the other end. It's a little four-wheel cart where you can probably put two or three buckets in it and then carry it down, drag it down and scoop and get a hand scoop and dump it over. But, you know, dragging that cart up, I mean, right now there's only like three lines of calves right now because there's like 91 calves still on the bottle. But when there's 230, you know, that becomes kind of a workout. So, you know, time's money. So faster you can get that done and get to something else done, it will end up paying off. And then plus, if you got guys that are a little happier, they may do a little better job. So, yeah, we'll just see how it works out. So, with that, thanks for watching. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. And we'll see you on the next one.